We begin this video with a thank you. We thank Andrea, who bought a t-shirt designed by you and who sent us a picture. So today, we have a voltage regulator, a stator from the PX, a brake switch from the GTR Sprint Veloce, and a commutator, as well as the electrical system. We'll see how to do the adaptation to make the TS and the like electronic. A premise. This type of modification is necessary to eliminate the point system and also to have a greater lighting power, because the stator of the PX has an effective 90 watts, and the circuit is only one, unlike how it is on the GTR, TS and Sprint Veloce. But be careful, this modification is feasible without replacing the engine block, which cannot be done because this modification is something that is generally also used for road circulation, and we are very attentive to this profile. That is, the recipes for the elaborations that go for racing are one thing. Another is what regards adaptations. Now, especially TS and Sprint Veloce in the last period have been produced with carters identical to that of the PX first series. Therefore, with the shaft of the PX and the large cone. In the end, the adaptation is very simple, and the engine of the TS, as you know, bears the same initials as that of the PX first series, VNL3M. On a GTR, there will be a problem. You have to resort to electronic ignitions that are sold in more expensive kits, but which are adaptable to those engines, because replacing the engine and circulating on the road is absolutely not possible. To be honest, we don't want to pass off this modification as ordinary, feasible and possible, because in reality characteristics are changed that would also require homologation. But it's quite another thing that an engine tuning that modifies its power. Here you don't change the cylinder capacity, the power, you don't change anything. It only makes the vehicle more reliable in the end. So these are things that should be within the bounds of permissibility. The case of the disc brake, for example, is quite different. They're going to bother you about the disc brake. To say many put the disc brake on the BX and that didn't have it originally. This is something that, because you can see it, it's very obvious. It's an alteration to the braking system. After this necessary premise, let's get to the point. So, we have an electric system. This is GTR, Sprint Veloce, and TS. They have a particularity, these electrical systems, which are divided into three branches and are made in reverse. That is, the circuit with the lights off, the respective branches are short-circuited. Therefore, there is a coil which feeds the stop, a winding, because then there are common coils, a winding which feeds the stop, a winding which feeds the position light, and a winding that feeds the big head light, the most powerful, the beam M, high beam, and also the horn in series. When the lights are off, and the stop pedal is not pressed, the respective branches are short-circuited, they are placed to mass. This is why the direct transplant cannot be done, because otherwise you either run with all the lights on and the stop pedal pushed a little without braking, or as you let go of something, everything goes out because it's shorted. After this necessary premise, we come to the operational phase. So, this is the PX stator. I won't dwell on what concerns the actual ignition, because that's an easy thing anyway. Instead of the coil, there will be the high voltage control unit. The usual white, red and green wires are attached, and everything runs smoothly. And for switching off, the red of the system is used, but it's only a matter of attaching the red of the system instead of the green of the switch off on the PX control unit, and it's finished. All very simple. The problem is with the lights. Well, these two wires, black and blue, are the ones that carry the current produced by the generator, the four coils. It's not that there's a negative and a positive, because this here is an alternator, so it's alternating. But the negative is then grounded, so the blue is the so-called positive. We can consider it as such, even if it's not. Then the negative, ground. And clearly this is the regulator, which will then need to be positioned in various ways. It can be made or attached to the ECU itself with an additional bracket, put like this, under a bent bracket that fixes it to one of the bolts that close the crankcases, and then a clamp that holds it to the ECU. You have to be careful, because hanging it alone can break something, so it has to be fixed. You need a rigid constraint. And this is a non-invasive way of doing it, as not to make holes in the bodywork, so as not to mess up prestigious Vespas. After that, then black mass and negative of the regulator, blue on the third tab, the last one. This here is the entrance, but this here is the positive output. The output positive must be connected to the system. And let's take the system. This is the part that goes to the wire box. Well, the negative always goes to the ground. And therefore, it must also be connected to the motor, clamped to ground and connected. All grounds must be together. It doesn't matter if with extension. Now, I haven't put any extension cords, but the important thing is that the short circuit is closed like this. After which the yellow isolates itself, the blue and the green join together, and the regulator output wire is brought to these eyelets. Therefore, the one which carries the stabilized current at 12 volts to power the system. I recommend making an eyelet in order to take advantage of the original wire box to do a clean job, and this stays that way. This is isolated, ready shut down, we talked about that, and black grounded. It's done. Then, we move on to the worst part. This here is light switch, here it is. So of course, the red that is shut down goes here. As usual, it stays the way it was. It goes off with the side mask key. And what changes? Since this is a switch that is designed to short, you need to cut the lead that goes to the high headlight switch. So this part stays whole, here needs to be cut. You take off a piece with nippers, you cut it here, and it stops here. After that, a jumper is made from the switch center. To this socket right here, which will therefore be number 3 because they are numbered. Here is the Taylor one anyway, because now turning it around becomes difficult. Here, this is how it looks on the Vespa, then there goes the lid. The bridge must be made in the upper part from here to here, a straight jumper, super easy to make, you weld it and it's done. Then, the mask that arrives here, because this here is the part that goes to the switch, comes out of the handlebar. The wires arrive at the back. The mask becomes too much and isolates itself. After that, then, the white, which goes to the so-called horn, even if it doesn't seem like a horn from the sound it makes, it goes to the center because it must remain in series. This right here is how the belt works, see? It's in series. So when it's short-circuited, when it is at rest and when it's disconnected, the current is forced to pass through the resistance of the bulbs. That's why the lights go down when you honk. Interferes with that for that reason. It's always in series. This is the case on all Vespas except those with the direct current type GL which have a battery. So we said the jumper goes here, here goes the white of the horn, and then at last the yellow, the position, and black stays out. After that, the green remains in its place where it went originally, and purple and brown, which are the ones that lead to the high and low beam, naturally on the side positions of the switch. It doesn't matter either one or the other, the switch is horizontal, but it doesn't matter at all because it just means having the low beam in this position or the other. And that's done. What's the only drawback? The only inconvenience that cannot be remedied without making other modifications is that the horn cannot sound in this way with the lights off, but you have to drive with the lights on. Who cares? Let's get to the stop. Now, in the meantime, you have to change the stop switch. It could also be changed, but it's not worth it. You have to get one like this, which makes the pedal stop circuit open in the rest position. When is the pedal at rest? When this button is pressed. You see that the contact is not here, and the contact is there when the stop is pressed and the button is released, and thus the circuit closes. The original one works the other way around because the circuit must be closed with the pedal in the rest position so that the relative coil is short-circuited. We have the opposite need, but replacing the switch is not enough. You need to make a small modification to the system and connect the wires from the new switch to either tab. Then the wires that arrive, blue and black, which will be these two that are the original ones that arrive at the switch, isolate themselves and leave themselves dead so that everything can be restored if necessary. Instead, if we pass the two wires that we have attached to the new switch, we leave them long and get under the tank. Under the tank we intercept, here it is. We find it like this. If the tank is here, inside the frame, towards the rear light we find this sheet wire, which contains three cables, the yellow which is that of the position, the black which is the ground, and the blue which is that of the stop. Then we cut it in a position that suits us. We cut the sheet and we release the blue wire. We take out a slot that can allow us to work. We cut the wire, and in series we join the cables that lead to the switch. So this switch will be interposed to this. It's like the switch is directly on the wire, and that the game, and then the this is finished. And when the stop is pressed, the circuit is closed and the stop will come on. If you like this video, leave a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Remember, Whitebone Racing is not a workshop, but an amateur sport association that works on engines only for sport purposes and only for its associates.